To create macros, you can use the built-in recorder or insert commands in the list. The recorder is very simple. Select what you want to record and press the record button. This will activate the recording hotkeys, which are by default F9 to start recording the selected macro and F10 to create a new macro in the same project and start recording there. Those functions are also in the Controls Toolbar. After recording, you can play the macro using the hotkeys or Controls Toolbar and edit the commands in the main window. Now let's create a simple macro by inserting commands in the list. We're going to build a copy and paste macro. There are several ways to insert keystrokes, like the text command window. If you need help with any of the command windows, right-click on an empty area and it will show you a context menu with links to AutoHotkey online help. Another way is the capture keys option. When you activate it, it will capture keys pressed on the list. When you push the green play button, it will activate your hotkeys. You can use either hotkeys or the controls toolbar to control playback, as well as the playback speed. You can set delays after the commands or use the pause command to make your macros more accurate. You can also set the number of repetitions for each command and for the current macro. I'll show you now some commonly used commands for automation of most windows. For that, we create a macro to open 7-zip file manager, go to a folder, select a file and click on a button. The run command window can be used to execute a program open on window or a file. To make sure your commands will be performed in the correct window, you can use window commands such as winActivate to bring a window to the foreground and winWaitActive to wait for the specified window before continuing. Click on the Get button to retrieve the title of a window. Activate the window and press the right button on the mouse to get the title. In some cases, the title will not be reliable, so it's best to use the Windows class instead. What's selected in the drop-down menu doesn't matter. You can even combine the options like title and class. To make sure in the correct folder, let's add a mouse move and click on the address part of the window. Clicks are relative to the window by default, so it shouldn't matter if it has moved to another part of the screen. Let's use the text command to type the address. And an enter keystrokes to open it. It's good to add a small pause between commands to avoid errors. Now let's add another move and click to select this file. Uncheck the roles you don't want to execute to test new commands. And another click on the test button. Now I'll switch to a different folder and close the program to test the macro. Here you go.